Most people think this vine should be in here. But we know it should be in here because we... Well, hello there. I'm Green Dean and welcome to my 105th video here on eattheweeds.com. So, why do people think this place is exactly where this vine should be? Oh, pardon me. Oh yes, thanks for coming by. Come on in, have a seat, but leave the door open. Please understand now that I'm talking to you as not as your manager, but as your personal friend, and I wouldn't be doing this unless I had to. But frankly, there's been some complaints. It's about your personal hygiene. You need to take a bath. To put it bluntly, from now on, you're in hot water.
Well, are you detecting a theme here? Good, there is one. The Padera Fetida has an aroma about it. Its local name is, or actually its colloquial name is, the skunk vine. Its first cousin is called the sewer vine. The Japanese are not too poetic about it. They call it the human gas vine. And the Chinese call it the chicken excrement vine. Frankly, I think they're being a bit excessive. There are two edibles locally that smell a lot worse. The passion flower, which smells like an old rotting gym shoe, and the bitter gourd, which smells like an old rotting gym shoe that's been in the bottom of a damp high school locker for a year. They're much worse, and they're edible. The Fetida is nowhere near that. Now, it does have a bit of a stale aroma to it, kind of like you've been camping for 3 weeks or something like that. But to me, it actually smells closer to raw broccoli or raw mustard or maybe Brussels sprouts cooking. Now, raw, it is eaten as a condiment with bland foods such as white rice. Cooked, it is a side dish. When cooked, it loses all of its aroma. It's reminiscent of broccoli with a slightly bitter aftertaste. It's also very nutritious and it's all over the place locally. Let's take a closer inside look at this vine. I just picked it from my yard. You know, it wasn't in my yard until recently. I've been here 10 years and all of a sudden this season, so I think a bird brought it. Notice the leaves are in pairs. Down here they're more on an oval to lance shape, whereas the younger ones are a lance shape. Very, very tough vine. But the most important identifying characteristic are called the stipules. And they're right here, and we're going to see if we can get a closer look at them. A major identifying characteristic of the Padera Fetida are little delta-shaped stipules. See that right there? See a little delta shape or a little hand shape? There's two of them. There's one on this side and one on the opposite side. So the leaf and its petiole comes in here. Leaf and petiole come in here. And opposite of these petioles, you'll see this little delta-shaped stipule, and there'll be one on the underside also. So there's always two of them. Now they're more pronounced on younger leaves than they are older ones, but if you look at a vine, you'll find two stipules on either side of the vine where the pairs of stems meet. And that's a major identifying characteristic. That little delta right there. One of my pet peeves, well actually I have enough pet peeves to open a zoo, but that's another story for another time. Our botanists who describe vines as going clockwise or counterclockwise, and that doesn't help at all. The Padera Fetida at eye level goes from your lower right to your upper left. And you can see it crossing this trunk right here. It goes from your lower right to your upper left, goes around and goes from your lower right to your upper left again. There's virtually, when you say something goes clockwise or counterclockwise, it's the perspective of the viewer, particularly if you're looking up or down. If I'm looking down at this vine, it actually looks like it goes clockwise. If I'm looking up at this vine, it looks like it goes counterclockwise. It's the same thing with water down drains, no matter where you are on Earth. The water goes down the drain the same direction everywhere as on Earth. The only difference is the perspective of the viewer. In some places, the viewer is upside down, and some places, the viewer is not upside down. So this particular plant, the Padera Fetida, twists, and it twists from your lower, at eye level, it twists from your lower right to your upper left.
Well, you're out in the field with Green Dean, and we're looking for some Padera Fetida, or skunk vine, in this good old natural environment, and I found some right here. As long as I don't fall in my pond. But here's some right here.
all these lungs and just growing up this tree. Now I'll grow up a telephone pole the same way, and it'll grow along a fence the same way, and grow across your bushes in your yard the same way. So it's a very, very invasive weed. Once you find it, you've got a lot of it. Don't think all skunk vines hard to get to. Just along this fence here. Matter of fact, this is where I got the vine for today's video and all the meals. A lot of nutrition sitting here. Pedaria fetida.
By the way, when you collect your leaves, make sure you collect only the leaves of the pedaria, because you don't want these that don't belong there, because you don't want inedible leaves. Let's see what we got here. Let's give it a try. Eat your heart out. Want some more of that. That's good stuff. My gosh. Skunk was never so good.
Here on Eat the Weeds, we itemize. Let's itemize the pedaria fetida, or skunk vine, and we start with identification. Well, as you can see, it's a very twining vine. It's in the coffee family, and at eye level, it twines from your lower right to your upper left. That's very important. The stems are usually green, and very, very top, this plant was actually imported to be a twine, to produce twine, so you can, as far as bushcrafting goes, it's a very good use for that. The leaves can be hairy or not hairy. They're usually oval to a lance shape and pointed. And they also come in pairs. That's very important, on opposite sides. And the stipules are very important. You have to look for those. They're a very important identifying mark. The leaves and stems have let's call it a disagreeable odor when crushed. I don't think they're that bad, personally. Flowers are small. They're grayish and lilac. And the fruit is little spheres like pearls that persist through the winter. If you break them open, they have two little black seeds in them. The fruit's not edible. The only thing you eat on this plant is the leaves. You either eat them raw or you can cook them. Time of year. Well, actually, it's available wherever it grows year-round until it gets killed off by a frost or a freeze. Where does it like to grow? Oh, disturbed areas, tree gaps. It can grow high in trees, creating a dense canopy. It can grow anywhere from a dry hammock to wet floodplains. And it can even grow underwater. It's found from the southern half of the United States into Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and it's an escaped ornamental just about anywhere in the world. It's also a nitrogen fixer, by the way. Method of preparation. That's pretty easy. Raw leaves. As they are, young and tender are always better. It has a sulfur compound to it, but very much like broccoli to me, but with a bitter aftertaste. It can also be cooked. The leaves can be cooked. They can be steamed. Usually this is raw. It's a condiment to go with bland foods such as white rice. Cooked, it's usually a side dish. You can make a soup out of this. You can add it to other steamed or actually boiled vegetables, or you can chop it up very finely and add it to salads. Well, thanks for joining me here in my 105th video, this time about the pedaria fetida, or skunk vine. I think it's a very maligned wild edible. I don't think it smells anywhere near as bad as what people say it does, and I think when you start to work with it, it reminds you very much of the mustard family. Now, if you want to read more about the pedaria fetida, you can go to eattheweeds.com and read about it, and also about 600 plants as well. So until next time, this is Green Dean. I want you to think green, I want you to eat green, I want you to live green too, and sometimes that includes a nice some food called pedaria fetida. Young and tender is always the best. I just don't know what all the stink is about. Toodles.